The Heat is all about a couple of lady cops. Actually, one is for the FBI. One is an FBI agent, and the other one is a local Boston cop. They get together to work on a case with a drug lord, and it is...
They're an odd couple. It's an old-fashioned buddy cop, odd couple movie, and these two ladies are like...
It has no foul language whatsoever, none. So... just bring your kids.
There's a lot of swearing, and I'm pretty sure it's R.
You can bring your children.
What do you call that here?
You can bring babies between the ages of
what do you call mature? What do you call that?
12.
Sophisticated language. 15.
It's 15 circle. Yeah.
No big deal. They'll love it. Kids will love it.
Tell us a bit about your characters, where they fit into it.
We play Beth and Gina. They are the two doctoral students who are...
We're the scumbag girlfriends of Melissa's brothers. It's unclear who Beth is dating. Maybe one, maybe all of them.
Minoring in Russian literature. Yes. In the original Russian
literature. I was
literature,
lucky enough to have some steamy sex scenes that got cut out of the movie with Joey McIntyre of New Kids on the Block. There's a lot of young women out there who would be quite jealous.
Very dramatic monologue.
Let's use the Boston accent. Harder, harder.
More, a lot of that,
like, what's it like working with the mercurial comedy talents of Melissa and Sandra?
It was pretty humbling, because it was amazing to see someone that you've watched for a long time. I've watched Sandra in Speed and Miss Congeniality, and you see her, you think, how could she possibly be cool and nice? And then she was cool and nice, which made me...
It was disappointing.
Sad.
To be honest.
Yeah.
It would have been a little easier to take if she was just sort of a jerk. You know what I mean?
Like, she did kind of flaunt the Oscar a little bit. That was weird.
But, you know, if I had one, I'd probably do the same.
I would have it right here with me
right now. I'd keep it in a Bjorn. I'd carry it around a Bjorn if I had one.
A baby Bjorn.
Melissa, I hear she was a little bit physically abusive, tearing your underwear off.
In the best possible way. I mean, honestly, you don't know. When you're working with someone who is a big star, you don't know if you can slap him around at all. And luckily, she pushed me first. So I got to push her back. But the truth is that that's the best thing that can happen for a comedian, is that you feel safe enough to do whatever you want and also push the boundaries as far as possible. And that's where the fun stuff comes from.
We're seeing a great resurgence at the moment of female-led comedies. Why do you think it is so important to see that in a male-dominated industry?
Men are done. Don't need them. And I don't mean just in comedy. I mean, it's over, boys.
If you think about it, you really only need one man to impregnate every woman in the world.
Take a break.
Think about that.
Have a seat.
I think they know their days are numbered. That's
Mama's
what I think.
Mama's got this. Yeah. Mama's got this. You guys can chill out.